Welcome everybody here to your coverage of the EIZO Cup. I'm your host TobiWan, bringing you your first game from the round of, well actually, first round at all. It's the first round of our teams where we have our boys that came through the qualifier going up against the invited teams before we get ourselves into those quarterfinal matches. So let's, without further ado, get ourselves into the game because that is what we came here to see and that's exactly what you will be able to see right now. We had ourselves a couple of delays coming into tonight. Main reason being those submissions with the patch servers, and for an hour we were stuck at a point where the patch would not go past that. Just that last 20 meg. 20 meg was all that was required to finish up the patch. And now it's done, so we're here inside the game. Decided to do KIS versus Team Life. You might also notice that Life, they are a team which you wouldn't instantly recognize their name, but you'll recognize all the players that are on their roster because they're their old Lions Pride is the best way of knowing them. So they're Team Life now. Lions Pride, the organization, basically disbanded, shut down, folded. You can check all the details that are out over on the news article on joinDOTA. But they are here playing tonight. They do have one stand in Rise. It's going to be playing with them this evening. But let's run through their lineup very, very quickly. So we'll be having Crit. We'll be running around as the Windrunner. We'll have Link into the role as the Weaver. Rise will be playing the Naga Siren. Rise taking more of a carry role normally. And looks like today will be no exception as well. So we'll have also Hester Joe moving in towards the middle lane. He's built for a bottle build, so we're looking at Nyx Assassin to actually go in for a carry build for the solo mid, puts Noir on the Batrider for the long lane, and that will leave actually Ryze as a supporter up here on the top lane. So Crit support Windrunner, Naga support on Ryze, and then Link as the hard farmer as the Weaver in this scenario. So I thought maybe they'll switch their lanes around a little bit, obviously not. And then through Roskits we'll have Vanskor. He will be taking up the role as the Chikiro. We've got the Flying Wing Boys. Yol will be there with him as the Visage. So Visage as well as Chikiro combo is what they'll search for. And then they have up on this top lane. Now, I know how to pronounce that, but I'm going to get back to you on that one. That's the Clockwork Goblin on the top lane. And then in towards the middle lane, we've got Jackal. It'll be, actually, I don't know if that's actually exactly who I think it is. Because I thought it was Jackal, but with Hyde and Jekyll next to him, maybe we'll find out for you. As well as Nose on the bottom lane. We don't definitely know his name. He'll be as the OD for this matchup tonight. So watching most CS is the way to go, but we'll check out our top lane. Link is going to be the one we want to keep our closest eye on. I'm also trying to check out with the admin who the hell these guys are. Get somebody searching for it. Lifesteal's not looking too healthy in the middle lane. And Chris able to just easily move this Clockwork out. The creep pull already managed to happen, but the Saturn Blast kind of made it a little bit, like for the small pull, the small holdback you get for those two creeps. It's just too much damage being taken by Clockwork for that one, but at least he's not having to burn through that salve just yet, so he's still got extra consumables. We're looking for a Courier Snipe right now. That's why Chikira has rotated himself over. The bottle is available for the next Assassin, but he hasn't picked it up just yet. Link, Link, and Ryze are moving in a long, long way here. A quick Riptide will hit both of them, but there's no hold down. There's no ensnare. There's no quick follow-up damage. All there is a Soul Assumption should be thrown back. But it's dangerous throwing that up before you hit level 2. See those two clarities up on Yoli. Needs the extra mana, and now that level 2 is there for Ryze. So ensnare, crit, well, he would like a shackle, but the Clockwork cogs keep him out. And keeps also Link forced to fight up against him. He can Shikuchi himself out there right now. And crit, there goes your shackle. Mad just a latch. Yol, this should be the first blood. They need the extra damage. It's just not there. 20 HP, the power shot used to attack on the Clockwork. But they cannot bring him down on the top lane. But Link and Crit definitely showing this double range from them is enough to hold them out, and with the range of Riptide, there's no issue as well with the Naga Siren adding her deeps to the mix. But it does give Weaver now 13. I was looking at the 12 for the Lifesteal in the middle lane. He's on the roll up against Hester Joe, so melee on melee there. Nyx Assassin not really having a great time. Taking only 7-3 up against a 14-3. It's So Hester Joe not controlling this lane anywhere near as well as he probably would have hoped. Like, he went the 1 point mana burn, sure he's going to take out the rage, the possibility of open wounds. So Lifestealer getting a kill here in the middle lane, the chances are very, very low. But at the same time, he's also very just happy to have as much Lifesteal as he wants to. Like, 2 points up in the feast. Yay! OD dies in the bottom lane. Damn you, Noya. We're off to a good start, peoples. We're off to a good start. Kind of worried that my focus wouldn't be here after 15 minutes of fun. Excuse is now over. First blood miss, but it is going to be Batrider taking out that OD on the bottom lane. So No's already having trouble. No's actually not having trouble at all when he's able to push Noya back like that. But the Batrider's already got the first blood, which means he's got the advantage. So we get bottle, we get full one, we've got normal boots. He's already off to a great start. And doesn't really require a lot of mana to go up against an OD. Because all OD's going to be doing is like stealing the mana away, but as long as you got enough of a mana pool that you can keep popping off that sticky napalm, and once your bottle's up and running as well, you should have no issue as well keeping your mana pool up. Even with the low mana pool, your bottle will just refresh it up quickly, and you can keep that sticky napalm going. Firefly also not that expensive, only 100 mana for that one. So with reasonable mana control, you can control up against that. Wow, that is just real overcommitment by Lifestealer. He's got his infest, and that's probably the reason why he's got a lot more confidence up his sleeve. Not to mention the stick charges he had. Dire's bottom tower, but that's still attack. Not enough just to get that close into Hester Joe, because Hester Joe's about to pop his level 6 too, so he's got that burst Vendetta. Downside Dire's for him right now is he doesn't have the mana attack to support that. This top lane starting to actually settle down after our first little bit of an engagement. I say settle down, then Yol gets ensnared. Ice Path just trying to keep him away, but the Shackle will lash to Yol because he backed himself up a little bit more. He put himself in line for the tree, and Link can't get himself close up with even with a power shot. If those cogs weren't there, he possibly could have finished the job. Now the ensnare goes on the Vanscore, but the Ice Path, the Rocker from Clockwork. Link has to Shikuchi himself away to safety while Chris taking too much damage from the creep wave, so he's forced to back up as well. I say he starts to settle itself down. Roska should be very, very lucky they got themselves out of that one. I say lucky, a lot of props should be going there to the Clockwork. Ryzen has Joe now, are they going to make them? Nah, they got no rune. 6 minute rune didn't spawn, it was a regeneration rune down the bottom lane. Nose. Wow, you're very, very low on life. That attack, ooh, 9 HP. With a sticky napalm on, it could have been very, very different. If OD also got one more attack, it could have been very, very different too. Clockwork threw the rocket down to that bottom lane. Traveled a very long way, but still was able to connect. But OD is not looking healthy down here. Even as he starts to tank up the creep wave. And Yol didn't bring him any kind of supplies. There's no salve, there's no nothing like that. If we look back over towards our middle lane still, Hester Joe's really just getting destroyed. There's nowhere near enough farm coming his way. Level 7.5 up against a level almost 7, now he does pop it. So the levels are staying close, and that's because Lifesteal's only got 10 denies, and 66% of experience still not going to make too much of a difference when it's melee versus melee. It's just how much farm is coming in. 36 to the 18 is the middle lane difference. Just like the bottom lane, OD is now up to 29 for 11, up against this long lane Batrider. Even with first blood, he's still sitting at 16-2. So life's not getting enough out of their lanes right now. Even though the golden experience kind of looks like it's going their way, the momentum on the core heroes here of RoX, KIS, they're going to be too much for them to handle when they go into that mid-game. We have to see Link with more farm than this as well. Like, he's 36 for 9. He is definitely keeping up with the Lifestealer, but the thing we know about a Weaver is Weaver requires more than just staying on par with farm for his opposite. Like, on this bottom lane, OD is the same, almost. Three less. Noya. Noya's now dead. Noya right in there, too. He's looking for the lasso so they can try and combine. They need an Napalm to slow somebody down. Flamebreak could do the job as well. Pushing Vanscore close enough. for the pullback. There's another stun available from Hester Joe, trying to hold him in the flames for the moment. With a mana burn, I don't think he's really got enough damage to finish this one. Maybe he does. Yes, he does. That melee range almost looking like a ranged attack. But a good rotation there from Life makes it 3-0, and they needed that. They need to shut down the OD. And they also got themselves a free gift of a support hero. Minose comes back as quickly as possible. There's this middle lane now they got to look towards. Lifestealer, definitely not the easiest hero to kill off. That, however, definitely helps. When you're able to get shackled, mana burnt, he's still got rage as well as infest, but he walks away from his own creep wave. Luckily for him, there's a new one coming in. The rocker will hit. He jumped into the creep and jumped straight back out again, but there's minimal life points he gets from that creep. And Critton has to Joe. Push him off the lane, push him away from the experience. And Nyx Assassin, even though he was missing out in that CS in the middle lane, his rotation made up for it. Also, I kind of like the new pattern they made for the best of one, best of two, best of three. It's a lot more obvious now, as opposed to the pips we had before. And yes, that's actually what it's called. They're called pips. Lifestealer. Holy Hannah, he does a lot of damage. And crit win run. Maybe that's what he was worried about. Open wounds. One more hit and he will go down here. But now rage has to be used. Is there a TP scroll? No, there's not. So Noya will stay with him. He's got 5-1 charges. So if he needed to, he possibly could have just lassoed that up. But decides that Firefly is a better option. And we'll take the kill on the Lifestealer. Gets split experience with Hester Joe, so it's not a huge amount of experience coming to the two cores that had to move in to get the kill. But it ain't too shabby. And that blink dagger for Noya. Who cares about experience? If he can get up to that 2150 and get that blink dagger up and running, then this map is a very scary place for RoxKiss. Nose can stop most people. Stop the initiation of the lasso, just gotta go straight in for that imprisonment. The downside for him is if he gets initiated himself, Clockwork is basically his only saving grace. Maybe in a long-range ice path to come out from Jakiro. Or at least hold Batrider there, but it's not going to stop Nose from being held inside the lasso and possibly napalmed or pulled through more Firefly. Hester Joe now going to find a free gold, and that is an easy stun. Power shot. No need for a shackle. He's going to use the mana burn instead. That one control ability of the stun was enough, and now a haste rune from Noya into the Firefly. He's moving away fast, and they're going to see him lasso and the shackle both being used. Not the best combination of abilities, and be careful with that OD ult. He's about to be dropped on three unless they can kill him up in time, which they do so. Hester Joe picks up a double kill, but they're going to lose two heroes for this. Hester Joe backs himself into a corner. The entire of the RoxKiss lineup rotated down to the bottom lane. The tower was killed off by the... Well, who was it? The tower was already taken out. They just dived themselves down. So Life are looking to take... Well, they took a 2-for-2 trade. They lost their Nyx Assassin. Batron was able to escape, but they lost the Windrunner. So they lost a core and support for taking out an OD and a support. Say, it's not a bad trade at the end of the day. And Lifestealer now comes to the top lane to defend his tower. Tower now within denial range because of the siege creep. Life can't really let this tower be denied. Lifesteal's already starting up on it. And the dire side should be able to see this. There goes the tower. Yeah, they would have been watching it. They got an aggressive observer ward there, so they should have been able to see that. But they are out of position. Also, another nice change to see that field of vision of the ward. Small things that come in patch locks. As well as breaking the patches. That's good to see it's finally here. Makes life a lot easier. Shame it doesn't take into account the fog of war. Show what it really sees. But just see that range of that one observer ward there. And then you see the new range of the sentries. Crit. Shackle will hold the Lifestealer out. Just Wind runs away before the Ice Plants can hold him in position. And Link. Well, he needs to be a lot more aggressive. It's one thing I kind of like, And hopefully we get to see Eternal Envy play on this live stream too. But when he plays his Weaver, he's one of the few Weavers which I actually enjoy watching. Most Weavers will just sit back, they'll continuously farm, they'll pick up a Lincoln Sphere, they maybe go into a Desolator, they'll maybe do this, and maybe do that. It's like, yeah, it's very, very slow and predictable. But one thing which I really enjoyed about watching with Eternal Envy's Weaver is the fact that he'd be over-aggressive with it. So Shikuchi in, do a lot of damage, and make the most out of your time-lapse. Like, if time-lapse is off cooldown, then you should be diving under, doing as much damage as possible to kill off the enemy hero. Or at least force him to walk all the way back to base. That way you're an aggressive presence in the lane, as opposed to just a player that waits for the creep wave to come back to you. So after 1 minute life, they're good to go again. Just a reminder too, guys, if you haven't done so already, head yourself over to the EIZO Cup. Either the website itself, izo-cup.com, where you can follow all the results for all the matches. Currently, 8 matches going on. Currently, Hester Joe dying in the middle lane and then into Vendetta. Just out of range of that sentry ward. So, was able to escape himself out. And they bring you more support. Blink deck is up. Noya! He misblinked! He was thinking about the lasso. The open winds have already gone off. Ice Path as well wants to hold Noya there. OD ulti with the soul assumption and the extra orbs and the familiars. That is some serious focus damage onto the Batrider. For the first time, he gets to use his Blink Dagger. And he may be regretting it right now. He blinked and couldn't get the latch on. It was just too far away. Yes, but for everyone else out there who, while things might chill itself down a little bit more on the map, head yourself over to izo-cup.com. Click on the Facebook link. You can go to the EIZO Cup Facebook page. And that is where you can sign up to see if you can kick my ass tomorrow evening. At this point, I am undefeated. Ooh, Spy Carapace, Rage War off, Power Shot as well. They've already lost one, and now Blink Lasso. They're just going to hold him there. But then again, they didn't drag him back into the Firefly, so there wasn't an extra damage crit. He's got a Power Shot available, but he knows while the Rage is still up, there's no point. Now he tried to line it up, but it's almost like this Lifesteal is trying to bait it. And it didn't work. Y'all will pick up a double kill from this. Batrider couldn't get back in there after using his Blink, after using his Lasso and having that Firefly getting closer and closer to cooldown. RoxKiss get a better trade-off with kills in the middle lane. It is, however, coming at an expense, and that's the Weaver on the top lane. Now to 2100 gold, he's getting closer and closer towards that Lincoln Sphere. And Ryan's getting more time to farm up on that bottom lane as the Naga Siren. It's only 22 for 4, but at least getting some space so he can find the levels. Probably the level 4 Riptide he's really in search of. Has a level 2 ensnare. Decent duration. 3 seconds for it. The longer they can keep those holds there, the more they can keep Lifestealer out of the fight. Hence it's worthwhile leveling it up. Hearing an infest now on the clockwork, or seeing an infest up now on the clockwork. A Dire Observer ward. Just watching over everything. Still giving space for Link to farm. With an ultimate orb up on him, he's getting more and more difficult to kill. They need to shut him down. Even though they have basically control up crit, they are still not controlling the other cores of life. Couple of kills here and there is not a bad thing, but life is still making the most out of all the lanes. They're keeping players in all three of their lanes. Clockwork, fail! Hit the familiars of Yol. That was meant to be for crit, and looks like Lifestealer just wants to bail out of this and says no more. Remember, guys, this is still only game one of the best of three. We're doing more games as well for you this evening. The winner of this, if predictions go correctly, they will be going up against Team Empire. And if predictions don't go correctly, we'll probably be doing SKZ versus IC Cup. Movement to the bottom lane, Noya, Firefly, Blink, Lasso. Ryze, try and time a little bit better. I think he's thinking about the ensnare, Astral Imprisonment, and Ryze just wants to bail himself out. OD, a very cheap and easy escape. If all you gotta do is Astral Imprison to escape from a two-man gank, which is with a Blink, Lasso, you realize the problem. There's not anywhere near enough damage coming out from life, and that was also with a DD rune. Oh, crit. Lifestealer, very precautionary infest. He's just doing it before he loses his mana by Hester Joe. How's Weaver still looking? Link's not really being that aggressive now that Nose is up here. Doesn't have a 4-star, still building into a mech, but probably isn't feeling the loving down on that bottom lane that he would like. So wants the easy farm up on the top lane. Time to go with a different build as well, with an OD going straight in for a deep build, as opposed to going for this build, which is heavily reliant on spamming mana. Ooh, clockwork, tried to latch something. Gonna find Link, he time-lapsed himself out. Shikuchi back off cooldown. Yeah, but most ODs will go into Tranquil Boots plus having the Buckler to start with, because you can use the Buckler to trigger off your Essence Aura. And then you could also be using your Tranquil Boots. Keeps your life up, but the Tranquil Boots will also trigger the Essence Aura. So that's the normal combination that people will search for. Top lane, a lot of players moving up here right now. Only one person is not, and that's the Lifestealer. Neuer and Hester Joe, they come up towards the top lane too, but this is basically a 4-on-3 scenario right now. Link, hiding in the tree line. Vanskor, he's so close, but he does not see Link. Even as Link moves out, Shikuchi won't have him being spotted out. Hester Joe, now in close. He's already used his imprisonment, so he knows there's no escape on him. Nice ice pump. That sentry ward from the Radiant side gave him a quick glimpse of where he was. Now in comes Neuer. The Blink Lance still is available. He's just trying to get himself down close enough, but with the Grave Chill, Yol won't be pulled back too fast. Ice pump. Now it holds Hester Joe. Yol needs more damage. It's just not there to kill off the Batrider. But with the extra support, they don't want to get in too deep. And Link, clockwork, ulti. Gonna go up to a familiar and they miss Link, throwing off the ice path. He hides in the tree line. Remember, this is nighttime, so he can be in there without being seen. And then turns around, Yol stops moving. So bugs, generate attack, Link. He's still got this, yeah, this time lapse out. Crit, power shot, Yol being hit by it. And Link can now finish off the job that he started before. OD ulti, Shikuchi out for the cogs and the macro pyre. Ensure he's held in there. Not to mention the extra dust that was used. Neuer very low on life. Familiars, they don't have that bonus damage, so killing off Neuer is difficult. And with the smoke, they can't easily get the kill. And the higher movement speed allows life to get back to the tier 1 tower safely. Shackle shot won't latch Vanskor. He's just up here by himself. But then again, Izzy, Lifestealer, runs in behind the tower. Starts up on crit, who's now windrun himself away. Flame break, trying to bounce the Lifestealer back. Successful at doing so. Follow up stun, hitting both the clockwork as well as the Lifestealer, who's taking up the tower with an imprisonment. What have we got? We got a shackle, and now crit. Well, Hyde moves himself back over there, able to kill off the windrunner, but does allow Hester Joe to escape. So the support taking it for the team. And Weave doesn't want to give this up. Moves to the top lane. He's going to get imprisoned up very, very quickly if he's not careful. He just wants to pull that creep wave aggro away. Fortification as well. Man, he's not making this easy for him. But Link can remain here close enough that he can attempt the denial. But when you're imprisoned, denial attempt will not work, especially when there's a chain of ice path. Clockwork and latch him in, and the macro pyre. Out of time left out quickly. The hold wasn't enough, and now Hyde dragged back by Neuer. Up with that Firefly, not quite there yet. Now it's up, but it's already too late. He's too slowed down, and the orbs from OD kill him off, and Link might be in the tree line, the dual breath. Trying to cut him off. Link, he actually had a path come for him by that power shot from the Windrunner. But he didn't feel the love and getting out of there. There's no gem up on RoX, so there's no problem with that one. Oop. Hester Joe. Actually, yeah, there is. RoX has had a gem up on Yol. I take it back. No wonder they're able to keep pursuing them beyond the range of that sentry ward. And now it goes 10-7. That experience of life. When they had to pull everybody to their lanes, they stopped loot. They lost that advantage they had before. Like, even though the kills were semi-even, maybe slightly the way of RoX KIS, they still had Ryze farming on that bottom lane. They still had the middle lane or the top lane being farmed up while the other lanes are being ganked up. And Ryze actually never came back there to help life. He just kept himself on that bottom lane, farming up. It's almost like they say that Naga Siren is now going to be the new carry in this game. The Weaver hasn't really got enough, and Weaver, well, at this point, the CS is enough. The kills, the deaths are too many. 1 for 2, 30 hard enough as a Weaver, getting your items up at a decent rate of time. let alone having two deaths to your name. You get a hero like Lifestealer. He's got rage, so it's basically like having a, well, your BKB, a 6 second duration BKB with Feast next or Lifesteal. And then you got Infest, so you may as well have yourself your own personal. I see it's even more than a mech. And then on top of that, he could now afford an armlet and still have 1,000 gold 22 minutes in. That's slow for him. Clockwork latches up, and he brings the Lifestealer with him. Hester Joe will now go down. No way to hide, trying to do it inside the Vendetta. But it was Yol who was in close enough with that gem. Got the vision, attempted denial, not gonna work. Blinks away very, very quickly once he sees Jakiro prepping up for that ice path. Meanwhile, up on that top lane, Link trying to do as much damage to this tower as possible. Cog's a little bit too far off, so the damage can keep coming, while Ryze continues to add pressure towards that bottom lane. I was wondering if he's going to go for like this all-in style of split push build and go for Radiance, but decides against it. Link knows he has to be careful. TP's even going to be cancelled. Moving to the bottom lane now. Lifestealer might get a little bit frustrated here with Ryze, who continues to farm up. Now, I said he normally plays the hard carry role and was looking to be a supporter here. But they're getting really greedy, Life. They want to have farm up on Nagasara, and they need to have a 4-star up on the Batrider, Windrunner. Like, it's the only core support, but even then, you've got Medallion to Courage up on her. And then the Weaver finished the full Linkosphere. Nyx Assassin, who started off in the mid, isn't going to go for aggression. He goes for the Ghost Scepter, so he can avoid the orb that comes out from OD, as well as Lifestealer's damage. This has to be a little bit more careful, because then Visage will be like, sweet, I've got a Magical Soul Assumption that's just looking to do a huge amount of burst damage. And Ghost Scepter will allow that to happen. Even more than normal. Crit. Gotta be careful. His familiars deal a lot of damage, especially once Nose is able to get himself an imprisonment off. Getting familiars into a position is a very simple task. Oh, this could be a frustrating lane. Get no experience for dealing with illusions that just take away your life, take away your armor, Radiance and can keep being spammed out at a consistent rate. Link, did he bring that tower within deny range? Yeah, he did. That's now going to be the second tower denied Radiance by RoX KIS. On the bright side, that will be the tier 1 and the tier 2 tower gone from the top, which means Link can move a lot more freely on this top lane, and he really should be too. He's going to be so aggressive on this Lifestealer. Linkosphere gets triggered, he just Shikuchi's around, and then we'll start up again and keep this Gemnet attack flying into Lifestealer. But then again, when he does something like this, he needs a time-lapse, the ice path! Combination time was just superb from RoX KIS. The clockwork to latch in. They realized maybe they wouldn't have enough damage as well, so we used the Infest as a safety. It was just a safety in case Weaver was able to time-lapse. And just didn't happen at the end of the day. Because RoX has got their timing perfect. So middle lane now being pushed up by RoX KIS, but the tier 2 tower will be lost in the bottom lane. This is that consistent pressure that Ryze has been adding time and time again. TP's will come back, so crit, power shots and shackles, the way to slow this down. Because they're not bringing the Naga back with him, Ryze. He has a TP scroll, so he can TP into an ultimate if he really wants to. Or ulti in TP. Hester Joe, there's your TP. That's coming from Weaver. Ice Path instantly wants to latch him. Familiar's not going to drop. Nice shackle up on Yol. But no one wants to think of his initiation. Not on Yol, at least. They try and go on the Lifestealer. You got Ashlyn imprisoned up. And then instantly raging to go on Hester Joe. And now Naga is back. The ensnare is there. The rage going to wear off. He was held there for way too long. OD ulti. Where goes the clockwork straight through the middle of it all. But knows. Got locked down and controlled up a little bit more. Link was already able to time lapse itself out in life. They haven't lost a single player just yet. Even with all these abilities of RoX KIS being spammed out, not a single ulti remains for them. And Noya trying to flame break. The clockwork back in closer. Nose is on the run, but Link directly after him. And with a double damage, Link will still say he's got this. Shikuchi threw one more point of damage, and there it is. 12-9 on the board, but life. They lose a tier 2 tower in the mid, but they push RoX KIS out, they fight him In a proper man fight too, even though Ryan's never even had to trigger his ulti for that, which means still Roshan is very much safe for life to go for. Can't attack with these illusions, but he can at least let them tank up against Roshan. Obviously, if they attack, they die. In comes Hester Joe. He's not really a tank. In fact, life, they're really missing a tank too. Link is basically their tankiest hero because he's got time lapse. Health-wise, it's Ryze. 13-12 to the 13-09, so it's not by much. But just because of his vitality booster. So this is taking a very, very long time, and they've got very low life. Familiars trying to come in. The general attack can't finish the job. Rocket will fly. Clockwork, you may as well ulti in. And nice, Noya body blocks him out. Ryze is still so low. The Familiars are going to stun down. They're going to finish up Roshan. The Rage was still there. Can they get out with such low life? Crit, I think he realizes he's dead right now. He dies off to the Familiars as they come back up again. And Link and Ryze will be able to bail out. Naga ulti, it's such a powerful controller around a Rosh pit. Just impossible to try and stop it. And even Lifesteal, like, he was raged up, but he was caught up on the high ground. He had to walk himself all the way around there. It's probably like, by the time I get there, it's already going to be too late, which it was. Just indecision coming up from the Lifestealer. But it means now an Aegis the Immortal is up on the Weaver. And that means that Link can go into a big damage dealing item and not have to worry too much. Monkey King Bar would probably be the best option for him. But he might even still think with the Lincoln's Fear, with all the ult, with all the abilities that have been coming his way, there's only one person that can control him if he has a BKB. And that is in fact Clockwork. The only ulti that will just stop him, and then the cogs. It's the only thing that will hold Weaver in position. But at the same time, Link needs damage. Desolator would be something I'd prefer to see on him. He needs that DPS. Because the rest of his team isn't giving it to him. They give him a medallion, they give him a blink lasso. Ryze gives him a riptide. Now it's going to probably be giving him a diffusal blade. Is that what's flying out in the courier? Yeah, it is. So now they'll bring a diffusal blade to the fight as well. So we'll add mana burn to the mix. So Ryan's starting to do a little bit more on the damage, but they need a lot more from Weaver. And looks now with an ultimate orb. Oh, I'm kind of hoping it's not a mana style. But I don't think we've got many other options. Could always look at a Lincoln's, but then again, no. We'll see. We will see. Clockwork. Having a look for that 30-minute rune. Building into his own BKB. Then the lasso will almost 100% have to be used for him. But then again, you got a Lifestealer on the field too. And a Lifestealer building into an Assault Cuirass. Ross Kiss, that's going to batten down the hatches for now. They know how much they lost during that last fight. So much experience when Roshan, and they've got to fight up against Aegis. No one wants to do that. I'd rather wait out the 6 minutes, they're already halfway through the time, just about to hit that 3 minute on the Rosh timer. And Blink Dagger for Hester Joe. Finally that comes up. So now Life have initiation that's not just the Batrider. So Batrider can focus on taking one person out, and he will probably look over towards that Clockwork. OD, for me, may be a better target now. He's got his own BKB up. Let the Naga hold out the Lifestealer with just the Ensnare. That's all they really require. Link's got to be very careful. He is going to go in for a Mana style. But there's one way to break that open wounds quickly. Makes him very difficult to kill off. Ooh, y'all should have seen that. Chikuchi damage. Takes off 1 point of the Gravekeeper's Cloak. Crit's looking over towards the middle lane, though. Familiars are holding them out. Throws a nice aggressive dire ward. They want to know when Ross can start to rotate around. It's also not a bad position to look out for those smoke ganks. AKA when the smoke is originally popped off. And right now, ganks are pretty easy enough. Clockwork, he's going to latch himself in. Tried to But his hook just not long enough. It's a lot of sentry wards around that middle lane for life. I think they've even got a little bit of an overlap. I don't think if I can select multiple wards at one time. Nope, I can't. For shame. But there is an overlap there. Just in this region here. They could have spaced out just a little bit better. But they seem to be happy. They at least know that if Frostkiss come up that middle lane, they will know. Straight away. Chikiro. Man, it's been a while since I've actually got to watch a Chikiro get to this level and farm. A Veil of Discord. Now up on him. Oh man, Roski still have such a big problem in that Naga. Sorry, lol. For people who get confused by what Benden just said, you can't change... Like, even if you change... You can't change your password once the game has started. And even if the password was changed after you connected into the lobby, you're still inside the game, and the password is nullified by then. So all you gotta do is just hit your reconnect button, and you're fine. Y'all. We got power shots now. Familiars. Clomping themselves down, needed extra damage, probably ready for this fight in Link. We'll try to do as much damage to this familiar as possible. He can't get close enough. If he does jump down further, he runs the risk of being lashed in by that clockwork. Which you know is going to happen again. Now that Assault Cuirass is done, Clockwork will look for the latch. There is a Radiant Observer ward that's giving him the vision over there. So this is what he's seeing right now. And he can see three targets, managed to latch in. The infest damage hits on two. Cogs didn't pop up. In fact, he went into a rocket barrage and then pushed himself a little bit further up so then he could grab out Noya, who gets nuked down. That orb from Noya, from Noya's really going to go to work. But now, with BKB's wearing off, it's a triple stun from Hester Joe. Wonderful ice path, Link. Time lapse, he's got time for it. Ryze has the DD rune as well, but now imprisoned up. And he's in trouble. Has to pop the ulti to escape from this one. Crit and Link can't really do much about it. They throw a rocket out. And Lifestealer wants to catch. Whoops! He turned around. I think the 4-star was meant to send him so he could chase down the Weaver. But they say ignore him. Batrider's down. Naga's ulti's down. Nyx is down. His ulti's on the sidelines. And that means mid-Rax is an opportunity. Push in hard, push in fast, take out the towers. And it won't take him long, especially when shackles don't latch. Imprisonments, familiars aren't moving to help him off. Just the ice part, the whole crit in position. They want more damage onto this tower. Link already has Lincoln Sphere triggered. And knows. Well, attacking the intel here on the other side, not always the best thing to try and do, but they didn't break the base. In fact, they did minimal damage, and they're losing familiars. I mean, I hope they manage to take out this tier 2 tower on the top lane, because all these oldies of life, they're back up again. Apart from Windrunner, she never wants to have her ultimate anyway. But she has a 4-staff now. And that's a very, very nice thing for her to have. More maneuverability, more ways to also push Roxkiss out of the fight. Top tower has fallen. Tier 2 tower does go down, but you instantly see the way life is trying to combat this. They push down the bottom lane. Link is trying to take out the tier 1 tower, forces one TP out by Nose, and the attack, well, Weaver's able to get the destroy on it. And Nose wants to keep following him, but he can't keep up. No way can he keep up. When Link stops like this, then it's like, okay. Dangerous. Realize too that Roskis now have themselves a gem. That was passed over again. Obviously, it was already up before. I was over on the Visage, but they've just given, maybe also with Visage's death, just took it off him. He's only got one death to his name. So I think Yol's been doing absolutely fine. And preparing himself for maybe the extra 1k item, but he's going to buy his Aghanim Scepter up pretty well straight. So there's no reason to really take it off him. Except for the fact that Clockwork is a better position during a fight. Okay, he's smack bang in the middle of it after he ulties himself in. And we're looking now as far as our advantage goes. Life, they're still managing to drag it back 2,000 gold, and they hold their experience advantage for now. Their only issue is going to be RoX. And if they're able to hold it, it's all going to come down to, well, it's not even split push. We don't have profits on this map. Naga's illusions are basically as close as we get to the split push. Three familiars now up in the air. How long to Rosh? Not long at all. Countdown's already there. So 20 seconds remaining. And then the next fight will begin. Life just trying to give as much momentum towards this top lane as possible before that does happen. Ryan's going to go on a level 2 defusal blade. I think he might just be saving for buyback now. Except the fact he's going to die. The illusion's just scanning out a little bit more. One by one, they all keep coming in. And then all three familiars drop down. Roshan's back up alive again. Very dangerous for RoX KIS to go into it. They know Ryze is ult, he can catch him out. You can't just throw a BKB off and expect the Naga ulti to come instantly. And the second you hear the Naga ulti, you're already gonna be silent, so, or asleep. That's a good creep wave on that top lane. I thought it was just push a little momentum. That's enough to force TP's back. And Hester Joe might be counting on it. He's waiting in the wings. Link Link's the one to come in. So a tier 3 tower for a tier 2 tower. RoX, this is now the bad trade for them. TP's on the way. And Nyx Assassin. They're ready to go. And that's what it is. Blink Lasso. Cogs just drags him straight over the top of it. And clockwork on the sideline. Familiars trying to... Wow, they do... Holy crap, they do a lot of damage. Noya forced to use his Ghost Scepter. Realize there's still a gem on the deck. Y'all, he's going to be the one to be brought down by Link. Familiars managed to drop down, so they still got that extra damage. That gem being claimed back. Yes, it has. Now the tier 3 tower gone down. And life, that will start to assault. Oh, Courier! Courier! Well, start to assault in the RoX. Three heroes to do so. Don't tell me there's no TPs. No TP, no TP. TP on cooldown. Oh man. No wonder they only brought two players back. They didn't have what they required to actually pull the rest of them back. And now with that, life have such a big space to take Roshan. That's decision making right there. That is just decision making. Who do you hold on to? Do you try and go for the push of the bottom lane? Do you defend your tier 3 tower? And all times, tier 3 tower will take precedence. Because that is going to be your RoX exposed. And bring one player back, especially that TP position. Clockwork going to latch in. Weaver, he's already got the Aegis. Four staff up. They lose the Batrider. They lose the Windrunner. Naga will throw the ulti out. Link Link does have this Aegis of the Immortal. He's trying to build into a butterfly. No time lapse available. He's going to go down right now. They're able to trigger off the Lincolns. There's no gem for them, however, so he's got to go Invis. Nyx with a stun three ways. Familiar damage. Link Ice Pot. He got Invis in time. But he's got to move faster inside the Shikushi. Now he can go again. Clockwork. No rocket. Nyx trying to babysit him up. Four staff looking for the cog bounce. Couldn't find it. And Link will even find himself a DD rune. But that was one big jump in from a clockwork. Life, I was with him, man. I sat here going, yeah, they got all the time in the world, all the space. Oh. Stun's going to stop the clockwork from going back. This is just frustration. He wanted to pick up his BKB, regenerate himself up, and then probably push out the bottom lane. Maybe help OD on that top lane. But just slowing him down means they might even get a pick off. No, Link. He doesn't have enough life points to dive back past the tower. Even with that talisman of evasion, he doesn't want to run the risk.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
The last added tower for RoX KIS. While that momentum keeps pushing in through that top, if life want to, they could slowly siege it up. But knowing how RoX KIS play, they wouldn't stand for that. They would come out and fight him. Leave whoever they needed to on that top lane to defend against the momentum. And go out there and see if they can pick off life. Because it's only going to be with pickoffs they can get themselves a victory here. And there it is. Smoke it up. The rocket might even slow down that top lane enough. It means they'll have enough time. They can move. Naga illusions only. Clockwork. There's no. So now he'll get the vision. Hex is up on Noya. Clockwork. He managed to get around the corner. And now BKBs. They drop the OD ulti. And search for Hester Joe. Very quickly running away. Batrider pops again. Crit refuses to use his 4-star. But he might have to. Naga says, I want out of here. The gem. It's probably safest on Ryze. Especially now he's got 5.6k. That's a hard if he so desires. Okay. Happy to feel the love, man. Happy to feel the love. And it's clockwork. Now he uninterrupted back. Ready to fire, but no TP scrolls again. No TP on the Visage, no TP on the Clockwork, no TP on the Life Sealer, TP on the Jakiro as well as the OD, and that's basically it. And they're basically back at their base anyway, so... TP, Boy Scouts thing, especially, like, it's what all Boy Scouts require. Especially when you're down to Rax, you need to make sure you can get yourself back. And Naga's doing this to you. She buys a full butterfly. So now we've got double evasion. This is forcing what has to be a Monkey King bar out from the Lifestealer. But then again, no, it doesn't. Because they've got the Scythe of Ice, it removes the evasion of the butterfly. So they're still able to kill off the person they want to. But they'll only get one of them. They'll either get Naga or they'll get Weaver. And Weaver is very, very close. 600 gold away from having the full butterfly done. Oh, hearing clockwork, latch down, they found Batrider again, 17 HP. It's a good thing he's got a Go Scepter. Didn't aggro the sleeping camp. Now the TP himself back out to safety again. Very fast on that Go Scepter, very fast on the 4-star out as well. And a smart TP. Blinked behind the tree line. A position the Ross kits would never really think to check. You normally, like, the default thing would be to get back in range of your tier 2 tower. But instead of going up that direction, he blinks from here over to here, or down to here, and then TP's out. Small things, wise choices. Lifestealer desperately trying to hold this bottom lane. We get next item up on the OD. Like, the mech's up in the OD. Actually saw a mech appear just before too. Yeah, crit. Only, like, what was that, a 43-minute mech? I think he managed to pick himself up. Not too shabby. And necro units come up from the mid-solo. This Nyx assassin. They just shifted their farm so quickly. Once they realized that Nyx wasn't going to do the job he needed to do, like, he rotated out, he found a couple of kills. That was great. But they threw as much money onto this Naga Siren as they possibly could. And they realized that Naga would have, like, this is going to go late game. So Naga had to have the high farm. And she's got it too. With that butterfly up and running, I'd still like to see that level 2 Diffusal Blade. It hasn't been purchased up just yet. Pick the butterfly over it. It's so cheap for the damage you get. Infest movement. 5-man smoke straight up the middle. And they found one. Noya, flame break. Still able to push him back, but the ice pump. Like 3 kills in a row now. Alright, it's just been Batrider. Gonna make that net worth of his 8.7k. But you got this 18,000 for 2 players as well. With Batrider down, initiations on a very, very low. And Roskis will just go for the GG now. Take the tower and move through. They may see if they can take a secondary Rax. But it's gonna be very difficult. Fortification's already slowing them down. Ryze adding a lot of pressure to the tier 3 tower in the bottom lane. Vanskor is the one trying to hold him out. Not seeing a full on. Well, it's Link League on the back of him, but they need to get closer for a shackle shot. Needs to be a 4-star. And now they'll turn. Hex up on Link. Blink into a stun. Hits on 2. The BKB and Rage went off from both the Clockwork as well as the Lifestealer, so they can stand their ground and fight. But Link having that time lapse, having extra evasion too. Able to survive, and Batrider will now respawn And that top lane momentum's gonna keep on coming. That's one of the reasons why Vensko had to come back. Not to mention he has to heal and get all of his mana back again. And Life, they're just storing this up until the next Roshan. They've got 3 minutes until he comes up. And then we'll be looking at Aegis and Cheese. And Life can then add their last point of pressure. And take out... Well, bottom Rax will be the main target. You on the Rax is on the biggest extremes of the map. So top lane and bottom lane. It's not bad. But they've still got a tier 2 tower to deal with there. It's amazing they're still standing. But then again, it's amazing that tier 2 tower in the bottom lane is still standing for Life as well. The Rocket searching for Roshan. Doesn't spawn up just yet. I mean, if RoX has actually noted the time correctly, it's 2 minutes until Roshan comes back. There it is. And moving down to the bottom lane, Ryze, as well as Crit. Ryze trying to hide himself in the tree line, and Nagaraldi, the only way he feels he can get out of that one. Clockwork, well, the possibility would have been there for him to ulti, but with an Observer Ward, they spot Crit moving out through the bottom. He should be getting himself into a corner. There's the Rocket, Clockwork, out of Latch out, and in they go. Four staff, Crit, Mech, Windrun, tries to line up another Shackle when this Rage gonna wear off. Oh, that line was almost right for him too. But he will go down, but while they're doing that, Link destroys the tier 2 tower in the mid. The top lane is actually a creep wave and a half, if not more. Now pushing it to the top, and remember it is Super Seismic creeps too. So there is a lot of options still for Life. They keep this map control going and they lose one person. That's not a bad thing. It stops RoX KIS from pushing into their base just because they must defend.
Boom, there it goes.
More pings coming out for Ryze. Sitting right on top of an Observer Ward. Still haven't seen this level 2 Diffuser Blade. Come on, Ryze. The Naga Illusions, they're able to scan at least the Familiars. Chilling in the middle, 30 seconds left. All ultis up for all teams. Apart from the ulti of Visage, looks like he only just resummoned them shortly. A short while ago. And the cooldown on Infest isn't that bad, 10 seconds. So they'll all be off cooldown for Roshan. And the Rockets continue to fly to see the preparation. Familiars as well moving in, and the Weavers. Well, oh wow, yeah. Had to stomp them down. Both the Weaver Illusion as well as the Familiars will see the spawn of Roshan. And that means down to the Crit. He should probably be power-shotting out this area here as much as he possibly can. He's got to clean up these Familiars as quickly as possible or else they're going to cause him issues during this. And they know it. Yeah, sees him. They got one. Oh, that's big miss micro. Down on one Familiar now. The Rocket will fly and they'll see him start up on Roshan, but one Familiar is a lot easier to deal with than three. Only one of the stuns now can affect him. And one Familiar to do that extra damage. It's a lot of damage though, 10 plus 98 at the first. And Roshan's basically done. It's too late. RoX gets out to realize that, so Cheese onto the Batrider. And Link will take the Aegis the Immortal still with 4,300 gold too. Hasn't spent that 2k gold up on Crit. Necrobook, now up to level 2 for the Nyx Assassin. And finally, Ryze spends his money, but not in the second level defusal. He's going to go into a heart now. Oh, you're killing me, Ryze. Bing, bing, bing. Someone is so going to make it. I don't know if people actually saw it too. For people who follow my Twitter, which is TobiWanDOTA, tweeted that before, and Cyborg Matt, you'll also follow him and you'll see it. Custom maps, they're coming to Dota 2. The first code was added. Matt was very, very happy when he sent me a message saying, yo man, you've got to check this out. I'm like, yes, the code is there. I'm just thinking, pinball with clockwork cogs. It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. The old classic slide games, they're coming back, peoples. And for everyone that loves them, the tower defenses, the malls, they'll return. Weaver, now gonna go into, well, okay, so we're looking at heart for the Weaver. I'm still not feeling the damage here. I'm still not feeling the damage. I'm feeling a lot of stability. But the more life points I see, the stronger I see lifestealer getting. I'm not seeing an assault cuirass up on anybody. And yep, there's the heart for Link. And the courier right next to the shop too. Because it's not stopping, okay, now it's stopping. So he will buy the straight up heart. So they just want stability so they can break the base. It's very, very dangerous though, because this could really kick him in the ass. If Lifestealer gets any higher level of control, like if those familiar stomps come off and there is no possibility for time lapse, not to mention that Abyssal Blade, you'll be seeing the bashes come, and now with BTs as well, Lifestealer can split push this and join his teammates whenever he has to. And they look for the openings, and they find one. Rockets down, they see crit clockwork. He lashed in front of crit. Lifestealer BTs himself in. Now he is able to get off that rage. Now the Lifestealer walks. Naga walked far enough away. Windrunner is the sacrificial lamb because look what's happening on the top. Link's on his way in. And he starts up on the mid tower. Leaves his Mana Star Illusions behind. All he wants to do is force these TPs back, and he got two of them. And that means that Noya. Co-Scepter helps him break free. Or at least helps him to stop the Lifestealer from chasing him too far. And now Abyssal. They need to stop him. OD! Big ulti, especially when Hester Zhao is in the middle of it. And now they go over to Ryze as well. The Grave Chill, the Ensnare, is just keeping that Lifestealer a little bit further away. The Heart's doing absolutely nothing for him now. Now that he's dead and Weaver, Link is the last hope. He'll time-lapse. He's looking for another Rax. Trying to keep that clockwork very much occupied. Another TP, it's going to be OD returning. And with that creep wave in through the top, Link can also harass on the bottom. Things are coming out, try and go for the tier 2 tower. Ryze is back, bought back into the game as well. Still crazy that we're 54 minutes in and that was his first death. Ensnare means Lifestealer's TP won't be stopped. But they wouldn't mind picking up a couple of these familiars. They can't be resummoned instantly. There goes one. There goes two. And they can't find the third. It's just a little bit of missed gold. When Visage respawns, they'll have to resummon them anyway. OD now going to go into... Oh, I don't know if it's going to be a late Link or if he's sinking you out a refresher. There's a full... She's got the full refresher. Up now on an OD. So we've got double the ulti from him. It's gonna hurt like hell. Especially with that intelligence difference. Jump around it. So you got OD. 92 plus 58. No one's really gonna match that. No one even comes close to matching that. Because no one's going intel items. Well, there's your last familiar. Does not want to resummon yet. Y'all is refusing to almost. Try to make this familiar be as much of a nuisance as possible. Ryze, please finish up your level 2 defusal. Aegis the Immortal. Man, it's still crazy they managed to survive the entire time because that's why Weaver had that. In fact, this may be the best time for Link to die. Stand his ground, do his damage. The egg is going to be reclaimed anyway, but he may not be sure, 100% sure of the time. So now, yes, turn 5. Lasso will hold the Lifestealer there. A follow-up stun. The TP's already going up from Vansko, but killing off Lifestealer is a lot more important. Infest in, and now Yol, Clockwork, and latch up. They found Noya. It took him too long to get this kill, and Lifestealer, he's able to stand his ground for just so damn long. The gem will be dropped, but when Clockwork comes in with a BKB and a battery assault and support from Yol, Life will lose almost all of their players. The Weaver Aegis doesn't time out. Ryze and crit. They've got to bring down this Rax fast. They've got double catapults pushing in. Lifestealer will TP himself, buy himself back for this. And the catapults are already starting up on the Rax. Weaver looks like he was able to pick off the clockwork on that top lane. And he's already into this man, into the mid. He wants this Rax dead. And he's got a lot of damage, especially when you got a double shackle. Lifestealer and Vanscore. This is just distraction. It's the middle lane. Fortification's the only thing that's stopping him from doing this. Ice Path, crippled die in this bottom. But the mid melee Rax is gone. Link is trying to force this into Mega Creeps. He should have a buyback available right now. Yes, he does. In fact, he's one of only two players on the map that has a buyback possibility. Shikushi in, back onto the Rax, and he brings it down. Now he has to get himself back out again. And you see RoX KIS. The call from Yol. Straight up the mid. It's the only option. There's only one range Rax left here for RoX KIS. And Link is not going to let him have it. In fact, he's already attacking on the tier 4 towers. Such a nuisance. Buys a Desolator. Comes down so he can pick it up. This is just so he can eat through the towers a little bit faster too with that negative armor. Locked in a corner. Time lapse. Not really a possibility right now. Especially when he takes. He's got to. He can't do it. That's also no buyback because he bought the Desolator. RoX KIS have a window of 90 seconds to push up that mid. That bottom lane will take out their range Rax, but the tier 3 tower is low. They'll have to go through the tier 4 towers, not even attack the Rax once. Focus 100% up on these towers if they want to get a GG out. This is all cards thrown in. Mega Creeps is not going to make this easy for him, however, and they're going to spawn on the 59 minute mark. The Necro units are just bringing down the Rax here, and they got him too. So Crit's going to have the bigger creeps as well, and already the base trade, it's not going to be fast enough. Vanskor comes up, the Hex up on Crit, Ice Path, bring down Windrunner very, very quickly, straight for the tier 4 towers, but really, it's already too late. You got Ryze, you got Noya, they're bringing down the throne, and the Radiant Ancient, it will go down. Vanskor, well, there's a TP back here, but it's for absolutely no reason apart from the casting Ice Path over his dead throne. 59-11. Life, they keep their wits about them. They got the lot better trade. Once that top Rax went down for RoX KIS, and I still can't believe RoX KIS allowed that to happen. Life, they just held their advantage. And they take game one here in the best of three. How are they going to go in game number two? Stay tuned. We'll be back here in just a short moment.